Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Plastic Empire Podcast. I'm Bill Singh.
I'm Alan Kaplan.
And this is Pedro Rodriguez. And we have, again, because of the popular demand, for the second time, Chris Starrett. Chris, how you doing?
Hey, guys. How are you all doing?
Chris, all right. Wait. That's not Chris. Chris, you look different.
I am future Chris. And because of being future Chris, I have the ability of hindsight, and using that ability, I would like to go back and make a few corrections, maybe apologies or whatever, referring to the first show.
Oh, that's awesome. But before you start, who wins the Super Bowl in 2020?
I'm not allowed. That, if it worked like that, I could have went back and just did the show differently, like perfect, and I wouldn't even have to. But you're not allowed to change major events or tell people about major events. You can only do little things like this.
Who was Chris Starrett of 2016?
Chris Starrett. 2016 is nobody, just another tremendous third-party nerd fan, and who, between the years of 2009 and 2014, I played a role in helping people start their own third parties, to get off the ground, and help communicate people in Hong Kong who spoke very good English but for some reason had a difficult time talking with stores here in America about, you know, detailed business, so I would help them out with that.
Usually the problem is that people in America don't speak English as well.
Well, that's part of it.
So what was that kind of, what kind of help was it that they were looking for? What is it that you provided for them?
Basically, and which is really cool because since the last time that I was on, I've had a couple designers that do stuff for Shapeways contact me off of from TFW. Shout out to TFW, and very nice guys. Very talented guys who did a lot of Shapeways stuff, and they just wanted to learn, you know, what is the difference between mass production and Shapeways, you know, 3D printing, and is it something that they would want to do? And, you know, I had to explain to them that, you know, most CAD programs that are made for mass production are for, like, human-like features, so it's especially made for rounded edges and such. And the one that you use for, like, transformers is something that's much less often used. It's not nearly as known as, like, your normal CAD program. It's a CAD program that is for, like, graphs and architecture, straight lines, and that's what its specialty is in.
If I could ask you, Chris, what's the deal with these CAD programs? Because I've heard people who are, like, architects do it, and can you explain the difference between one that I guess what the difference is between one and the other? Like, how would you get access to a transformer making CAD program?
Well, okay, yeah, I know it sounds stupid for me not to know exactly what they're called and everything, but when I would be dealing with the designers, like, there is, like, a CAD design that everybody uses. It's just like when people think CAD, they use this program. And that particular program, like I was saying, is very much structured around rounded edges, human-like or animal-like features, which doesn't translate well at all to making transformers and straight lines, pieces that have to perfectly interlock. That's where the architectural type of CAD program, I'll find out specifically but it's straight lines. Basically, you go from curved lines, which is what everybody uses on CAD. That's a normal CAD program, but there's a lesser-known CAD program that's all about straight lines. That's what you got to use for mass production.
Very cool. And
yes.
Oh no, go right ahead.
Well, some of the things that I did want to straighten out and just go back over corrections and that and misunderstandings. I'm gonna have to pull up TFW because there was some awesome support. That's the main thing I want to do. You know, I thank you guys for letting me be on the show, but I know how the internet works, and I know that 9 out of 10, you know, people that are going to reply are usually going to reply negatively. The amount of positive reinforcement, encouragement, and kind words that I've received has been completely overwhelming. And I asked for none of my friends. I told nobody about the podcast. I didn't ask for any support from anywhere, but it just seems like people were able to tell that regardless of what anyone else says, like, I'm telling you the truth. I don't, like I said before, I don't waste my breath with lies. I'm just telling you my story, what I experienced. People could have been lying to me, you know. I honestly still to this day will not believe that my brother Keith, that I had talked to before, who is sick in the hospital right now, he would ever lie to me. I will never believe that until he tells me it or something along those lines. But I wanted to get back to some of the mistakes I was talking about. I did want, I don't know if I led people to believe this, but I noticed on TFW and on Shatteredcast, which is a podcast I love a lot, Toy Detox and Shatteredcast, they're awesome. They had brought up the middleman possibly being Keith, and I wanted to make sure that was clear that it definitely isn't Keith. That's not who I was talking about.
Which Keith?
There's two Keith
X. Not my Keith, Keith X. And from now on, and I'll explain why in a minute, I'm going to refer to Keith X as Mr. X because I'll explain in a moment.
And who is Mr. X?
Mr. X.
Who is he?
X.
Mr.
Keith X.
Who is Mr. X?
See, that's the thing. Some things have obviously changed. A lot of people have gotten in contact with me. I thought that I was deep in the third-party world before. It's like everybody and their little brother contacted me. People who don't contact anyone, period, have contacted me. And, you know, everything from owners to designers. And they're just like, well, you got this, this, and this right. You got this wrong. I feel like 50% of them are genuine, 25% of them are trying to figure out what I knew, and the other 25% were like trying to like throw me, like just totally lie to me, because, you know, it's one thing if I'm mistaken about something, but it's another thing if you knew you did something. You know what I mean? It's like, no, I remember working on this shit for months. Like, you can't tell me I wasn't there and I wasn't a part of it. You know what I mean? Like, no, it just doesn't work that way. But anyways, so Keith X is not this middleman that I'm talking about. We're going to refer to him as Mr. X. Reason being is because
Just one second. Just because I'm a little bit confused. Mr. X, if Keith X, is not the middleman. And if he's not the middleman, then who is he?
In my day, there was an individual that if you contacted KFC, Keith's Fantasy Club or whatever, he would answer to you as Keith X. In my day, he was also the owner of Unique Toys, DX9, X-Transbots, blah, 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 like we had talked about before. He owned many, many companies. The reason why I'm going to call him Mr. X from now on is because of all this information that has come to me in this past 2 weeks. A lot of it might be misinformation, a lot of it might not be. Whatever the situation is, a lot of people are trying to claim that there are multiple people going by the name of Keith X now. Whether or not this is true, I mean, ironically, my best friend, brother Keith, his real name isn't Keith, but I mean, that's what he goes by. You know what I mean? And Keith X actually told my brother Keith, I'm naming KFC after you. It's Keith's Fantasy Club after you. And my friend's like, no, you're not. You're naming it after yourself. Don't try to pull. But anyways, so for now on, I'm going
to
refer.
There seems to be a rash of Keith's. Keith's.
Keith's.
Wow. But go on, man.
So whether or not there's a million people going by Keith X right now or not, that is, I mean, like I said, I ain't in it right now. You know, I'm getting info from all over the places. I'm going to have to figure out who's telling the truth. I got one guy that I really, really believe because he just, the stuff that he's done and that he's been able to show me has really kind of proved who he is type deal. And so for now on, I mean, if there's going to be speculation, if there's going to be any of that, we're going to keep fact, opinion, and hypotheses and all that separate so people don't have any misconceptions or misunderstandings. Another misunderstanding was many people on TFW and on and I think it was mentioned on Shattered Cast had said that I had said that Takara was going to release an MP every month. I don't believe that's what I said. A few people went back and listened and told me it's not what I said. What I meant to say and what I hope I said was every other month. And that goes in line with the year of the Decepticon. Five Combaticons every other month, and I said on the 10th month you would have a complete combiner, and on the 12th month you would have gotten MP Galvatron.
But Chris, so what you're saying is that you're human, you make mistakes, and people on the internet love to point that out immediately, and they think they're the first ones and the only ones to bring it up. But
yes,
yeah,
yes,
don't do it again, Chris. Please don't.
Bill.
Because we're not because we're the first ones to point out Pedro, just nonstop talks. So internet, you're not the first people to call that out. Go check some of our past episodes.
Yeah, we gotta have somebody to keep the ball rolling and to keep people like me on track. So, I really want to get through the nonsense so we can have fun. Because that's what this is supposed to be, just a bunch of guys having fun, you know what I mean? Okay, when I said four people running things, that was some stupid shit, I admit it. Because honestly, though, me putting the Canadian guys all into one group, that's dumb. Everybody knows Fans Project, Make Toys, and MMC are three different companies, three different owners. Now, we could speculate they're from Canada, we could call them the Canada team, we don't mean that I've been to Canada and met every one of the owners and know for a fact. You know what I mean? So I had lumped them into the four. So if you add those three, we got six right now. I totally forgot about iGear. That was stupid. So we got seven. There's seven major players at that time that I was aware of. That's all we knew about. And I know there's a lot of people talking about all these factories and shit. It might be that way today. People might have got rich and bought their own factories, but back then, there weren't a bunch of factories. Matter of fact, I'm going to blow what was considered the biggest secret in third-party world. This was considered the biggest secret. Now, the reason why I'm blowing this secret, I want to make clear, because we do have these people that are going to come back. I'm sure it's not the case anymore. But during my day, most third parties were all made at the same company, or same factory. Matter of fact, all their casts were kept in the same closet. Jeez. You'd have one company's cast here, another cast here, and they're all...
Could that explain why sometimes things were late or would take a while to come out? Because they were waiting for the previous, the other company stuff to be produced before they can mail out theirs?
Well, see, that brings up another thing, the sabotage point. I'm not going to confirm sabotage on that yellow figure right now, but I'm going to let you know. On Shattered Cast, they had a guy that they trust that's out of England, and his name is Genetic. I don't know the guy. I swear I've talked to him before, but other one way or another, God bless the dude. He's obviously a good guy, and he confirmed with the Shattered Cash crew, hey, you know, these things that Chris was saying was right. He was like, when he said the middleman control sold to all the Western Hemisphere stores, he said they asked him if that was true, and he said, take out Western Hemisphere, and you've got it right, meaning he's the middleman for the whole world. Now, don't get it confused. I can understand why you would get it confused, because I messed up. I have really bad anxiety. I got caught off guard, and some of the things I was so caught up, I got perplexed. And one of them was, whenever we brought up going through the middleman, you had said basically one of us had said all of the companies have to play ball with this middleman. Not true. Yes, if they want to have product in his store, they have to go by his rules. If they
that reveals another layer.
Okay, but if this middleman, he was able, because many companies, almost all the ones we had, nobody has startup money, nobody has money. You know what I mean? So it takes stores. You know, a lot of our favorite companies were given startup money by our favorite stores. That's where they got their start. And bring me back. Where was I going with this?
You were going with how many that you were going with that all the all the companies are done by one middleman, which it wasn't.
Right.
But if you wanted to do the middleman store.
Right. And that's the reason why some, you know, maybe some companies might not sell to them. Some of them went along with the plan. Some of them had to, because I don't know if I mentioned it last time, but in the beginning of my third-party experience, say the stores would order, say, 300 or 500 units of something, right? Towards 2014, our orders were for 76 pieces, 38 pieces. So if you had a run of 1,000, and between all the stores in the world, you've only sold 250, you're looking at some huge losses and not getting your money back for a long time. So smaller companies would agree to sell their entire runs to the middleman. That way they were guaranteed the money they wanted back so they could go on with something else.
That makes sense.
That makes sense. I mean, like you said, the startup money is not there, you know, and they don't want to take that risk. You don't sell it, you sit on it.
Right.
So they're kind of at, like you said, at the mercy of the middleman.
Yeah.
Like a certain yellow transformer, which has been reduced by almost 45% on a certain popular toy store today.
I will not. I got yelled at. I'm not going to say anything about that one, but I will confirm. Because not only my experiences, I've had several designers and owners say they are sabotaging each other over there. They are stealing each other's cast. They're taking each other's employees, their designers. And we can even get worse than that, you know, personal stuff. So there is sabotage. There is stuff going on. There is fuckery, as you know, some people would say, going on. I did want to confirm that. I don't, you know, I was really kind of iffy about that, but, you know, with confirmation and just, I mean, I was sabotaged. I got screwed over, you know what I mean?
Oh.
So I wanted to go over that. One thing I do want to say while I have a moment, I'm on my soapbox, about me, I was talking about my credentials. You know, I started off with getting Dr. Wu off the ground with my brother Keith. And then we got a lot of my friends' companies together. Something else about me is that 18 years old, I decided I was stupid enough to believe that I had to choose between good or evil. I chose good. I have focused on honor and honesty, transparency, and world peace ever since then, and I'm almost 38 now. So that's why I'm not going to be in a rush to argue with people about my honesty, because I don't have to think about what I say, because I'm so honest and compassionate. I don't have to worry about, I don't have to do that stuff, and I'm not going to.
That's the internet, and you are absolutely unbelievable, okay? And the stuff that you say just rings. First of all, it sounds like it doesn't sound like it's something fantastical. It sounds like something that makes sense, that considering human nature, and from what we've seen, when we've seen on the forums, you've had some very reputable people back you up.
Mm-hmm. I would like to tell Pia, and excuse me, brother, I know you by your real name, not by your alias, because, you know, we've talked for a while. Pia not only has the sexiest voice on the planet, I swear, I wish I could just...
He absolutely does.
I mean, I want him to tell me lullabies at night, every night. It's just, I don't know what it is about the guy. Plus, he's the nicest guy ever.
I want PR to read me the instructions on how to put together an IKEA table.
Yo, if he tried to read you anything, you'd interrupt him every 2 minutes. So he wouldn't even be able to get a chance.
Only to applaud him. Only to be like, oh my God, that's so great. You sound wonderful. Go on.
Emgo has a sexy voice.
Put the peg in slot A and then...
No, it's not the same. It's not the same as PR.
Can you tell me how...
Hey, Bill, you're breaking up. I can't hear you.
Oh,
yeah, what'd you say, Bill?
I'm just messing around about PR.
Bill in black and white. Bill is in black and white because he's a classical. He's
because
classic.
Bill is black and white. There's no gray with Bill. It's black or white. And that's what I love. You get what you get with Bill, black or white.
New world order.
But again, along those lines, again, I just... like I was saying, I wanted to thank everybody's support. PR was incredible. There was a guy on there, Nighthawk. Just so many Oku. Some guy with the there have been people on YouTube, TFW, and Facebook coming out of the woodworks, just supportive. And I can't help but think, and I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, but like I said before, game recognizes game. Honor recognizes honor. It don't matter if I got anxiety disorder and I'm nervous and I'm ill prepared and I'm not well spoken. You can still tell I'm an honest person. That I'm telling the truth. You know what I mean? And that I'm not going to lie to anybody or take advantage of anybody. Sorry, Bill.
The detractors are always going to detract regardless. You'll never win the internet, whether it's negative or positive.
Bill is right. You'll never be more honest. It's not going to happen. But we know the listeners and the people that are actually interested in this, they know that because, A, you do come off as somebody who doesn't – why are you coming up with this fantastic? Are you looking for attention? You don't need – I mean, people hate, and they're going to hate for hating. And you know what? Let them hate because they're just another view.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, yeah, and I respect their view, and may God bless them. And that's all I know to say about
that. You're much nicer than I am. You're much nicer than I am.
We had a console Pedro at the barbecue, that's for sure. I mean,
oh, my God. I wasn't cool.
He was off in the corner rocking.
Oh, no.
Yep. The internet hates me. Poor Pedro, man.
No, bro.
Actually, Pedro, you should get one of those jerseys. They hate me, you know, from back in the day.
Oh, they hate me, yes.
They hate me.
No, Chris, they're pulling your leg, Chris.
I just pictured you in a fetal position in the shower.
I only cry on the inside. The shower is one place, though, where I will cry, but I just cry on the inside in my room.
Nobody can see his tears.
Listening to my Tori Amos albums.
Hey, that's the next TPT shirt.
Killing me.
I never shut up.
That's it.
Okay, I'm sorry. This is taking forever. I apologize,
Go right ahead.
I feel that it was really important. I spent a lot of time going over this one of my very favorite Transformers, this this part swap I was telling you about. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to let you know, I was so stupid. This was done by Arizona Dragon. And I just wanted to show, that is the only thing that got painted is the shoulder.
Can you move back a little bit? Little bit so we can see a little bit. But yeah.
Okay, now if you see, that's the original symbol. You know how tiny that is, and he painted all that inside there. That's how good he is.
That wow. I was surprised because I understood, because this is the Black Optimus Prime, the MP10B, and then he put all the gold pieces from the Year of the Horse. But I can't believe what he did with the shoulders. I was like, where did you get the Year of the Horse shoulder? So he painted inside of the Autobot and the horse symbol.
Yeah, and I just had to give him the proper respect because there's not very many customizers. What's that?
It was a little difficult to hear.
What was?
What you just said.
I don't know of very many customizers at all that could do that. This kind of detail. I mean, this is a totally different version of it. And you can see, like, no imperfection.
Yeah. You got two things?
And you got two.
Send me one.
Robot and alt mode.
Well, I got this one for a friend who's so rich, he doesn't have room for it, so I get to keep it here.
So send it over.
Wait, why can't he keep it?
Because he has two houses that are completely full of toys.
That's awesome.
And a storage unit.
Sounds like Pedro.
I'm getting there.
That was the inside. I wanted it to make it. You know how his trailer disappears? I've got two different versions of the trailer going into like a cloaking version.
But
this was done by Arizona. This was done by Arizona Dragon as well. And I just wanted to give him the proper respect because. He's a great customizer, and he deserves, you know, a shout-out for, especially when I spend so much time, like, showing it.
The Year of the Horse Optimus Prime came with a clear trailer. So for him to do that paint app, I mean, that is professional. I'm telling you, that shoulder didn't look, it was like, it was painted differently compared to the rest of the robot. Okay, we've lost Chris.
He's going to get something else.
He's taking a special break.
Special.
Oh, there you go.
A bubbly break. What do we got here? Let me present you to everyone. There's the clear trailer. And he took that and painted it with the black and had the cloaking.
Yes.
Looking good.
You got the black one, and then you got one for regular Optimus Prime. But it's done in a different way. This is like circuitry, you know,
Wait a minute. Can I see the other one again? Oh, Bill, I just realized this one is also painted, the one on the bottom. The guy painted the right-hand side to look like
he
the
did.
Original trailer. The left is the clear. That is awesome.
Okay, so he painted. Okay,
so I'm sorry. Was that loud? I'm sorry.
Now, explain this cloaked trailer. What did this come with?
These are two. This is the Year of the Horse clear trailer that came with Year of the Horse, and this is my explanation of where the G1 trailer would disappear whenever Optimus Prime would transform. I figured it just cloaked itself.
Gotcha.
Sorry, Chris, you're a little low.
Oh, I'm low on volume?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're low on the microphone.
Okay.
Bill, what he said it was exactly it. In the G1 cartoon, Optimus Prime would transform. There you go. That's better. Optimus Prime would transform from trailer to robot form, and mysteriously his back the back trailer would disappear.
Disappear, right?
So it's just our little explanation of where it went. But anyways, okay, we're gonna finish this up real quick now. Okay. Brock Lesnar's name. Somebody questioned, how can you be big in MMA and forget Brock Lesnar's name? I'll tell you why. Because I was anxious and nervous, and when you're anxious and nervous, and have been drinking a little bit to kind of chill the nerves, your brain can go blank.
Messing with
Wait. Someone called you shit for forgetting Brock Lesnar's name? Amongst everything else?
The internet!
But amongst everything else that we're talking about here.
Listen, I still get
like, how can you be into MMA and not know Brock Lesnar's name? And I was he failed two tests,
so...
He's not in MMA anymore.
Well, he is, technically. But he failed two tests. So.
I don't know. That last, even I found out about that his latest news cycle.
Huh. Oh, really?
Yes.
I still get nervous before the show, so don't sweat it, man. I mean,
and Chris, you just need to hang out more with us. We don't care. We don't have we have very few friends. We have each other and a few others.
Jesus Christ, speak for yourself, pal.
No,
I don't want everybody out there to just completely think we're losers, man. Relax.
No, honestly, if it wasn't for the three of you being so rad and all the support from people like PR and this not all you guys from TFW, I'm sorry I don't remember your names. I know I mentioned Genetic. There were so many people that were just so supportive. And if it wasn't for you guys and for these people, I wouldn't have had the balls to do it. Because last time, when you have anxiety, when something sprang on you, it's almost better than being able to think about it. I had 2 weeks to think about possibly being on live video again, and that had me having panic attacks here and there, you know, getting really worried. So anyways, Dr. Wu, one thing, remember when you brought up Perfect Effect Reflector?
Yeah.
I know that a few people were upset about that. I thought it was a good thing to bring it up because a little bit of history. But also, I knew, because I had said I had all three versions of it, and you had said two. Don't you remember that there was the all-black BotCon version?
Oh, no, I did. You're right. No, you're right.
There were three.
Wow, yes, good call.
I couldn't think about that.
Yeah, and the thing about people complaining about the Perfect Effect, hey, it's a third-party item. I took, five, ten minutes talking about a third-party item that was produced between 2007 and 2009 and 2014. But anyway.
Well, no, I mean, sometimes you got to go back because, you know, that was another thing that whenever we actually got to starting the show, I wanted to say is a lot of people don't get a lot of these companies that we talked trash about in the past that were garbage, that made garbage, are now our favorite companies.
Oh.
And I'm going, just to make it better, I am going to ask these companies, I will not reveal who you are now, but can I tell people who you used to be? Like, say, one of our favorite companies used to be so-and-so. And everybody could be like, dude, that was the crappiest shit on earth. And then you could be like, yeah, but their MPs are the best now. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's what I love when
that
I
happens.
That's what I love when I hear these when I read these declarations on forums, on Facebook, or on YouTube, or Facebook that this figure that was released by them was crap. I am never buying any product from that company ever again. And lo and behold, you changed the label, but you still what are you gonna do?
Oh, that was funny. Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, I find that happens in the toy industry altogether. You got people saying, I'll never buy another Hasbro product again, I'll never buy another Mattel product again, blah, 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 and then they're on the next month complaining about it. You know, it's all just noise. At the end of the day, everybody has their addicts, and they have what they're addicted to, and they're not going to stay away.
I agree completely. What do you think, Bill?
I am sending a message, sorry.
Oh, it's like I got girls and different area codes I got to tend to. Like, come on now.
Actually, I'm addressing the feedback. Who's watching us on YouTube mid-show?
Oh, hey, shout out to
Bill. Your audio is off as well.
As long as you can hear it, it doesn't matter if it's off.
Mm. Oh, that's the problem. I can't hear it. Oh, fine. All right.
Can you hear me?
I hear you.
Yeah, you're fine.
Well, no, so you could hear me and Alan, but not Bill?
I mean, just some of the stuff. I don't know, Alan. Did you hear anything about that? Did you Does he sound fine to you, Alan?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, then it's just me. Sorry.
All I'm saying is, it sounds like somebody's watching the YouTube while we're recording. So mute that tab if you're gonna watch.
Okay.
I apologize that I wasn't paying attention.
Sorry, Chris. Technical difficulties. But
hey, man, we're just here for fun. Hey,
I didn't hear at all what he said. Not at all.
No, that's because I interrupted him. I'm sorry. What would you say?
Are you taking the role of Pedro this week? Is that what you're saying?
I don't call it interrupting. I call it dynamic conversation.
There you go. Listen, here's what we'll do. We're kind of getting off track. Let's reel it back in. Let's decide what you just tell us what you want, what else you want to tell everyone, and what other information you want to get out there.
I only got one more thing as far as the whole clearing things up, because honestly, anything that had to do with my opinion or my belief or I don't need to apologize for it. It's my experience. It's my belief. It's what I've experienced, so it's what my reality, okay? So I don't have to apologize for it. But I will address this. On TFW, it turns out that somebody claiming to be Dr. Wu himself has gone onto a Chinese website denouncing me 100%. Not just denouncing me, but telling me that I was full of horse shit, that I was a liar, that he has no idea who I am, and all this stuff. Now, that hurt a lot, but it hurt a lot regardless, but I did have hope in my heart that this was like a troll or somebody pretending, because I have this to go by. Dr. Wu has never commented on any forum anywhere. He's had people do it for him, but he doesn't do that. He doesn't go on the internet, and he doesn't cuss. But then again, the guy I was telling you about that contacted me, that I'm kind of believing that he's into it, he's telling me it is the real Dr. Wu, but he said that there's something. He said because things have changed since you've been around, he cannot be correlated with you, or he has to deny knowing you. I don't know what it is. I don't even know if it's the real Dr. Wu, but I don't want to pretend like I'm hiding from anything. Even though this is on a Chinese site that unless you know Chinese, you're not going to know about it, I'm going to be honest about it. The actual guy I'm claiming to give his start to, and that started me in the third-party world, is denouncing me. Somebody with his title is denouncing me.
Let that guy show up on the Plastic Empire on a video cast and explain it. Until then, it's just another asshole behind the computer typing away. All right,
it doesn't sound like he's that type of guy either. Like you said, I mean, you know, he sounds like a guy who's not out there wanting to be in the public eye. He's not. Mm-hmm. He's a very reserved type of gentleman. So, you know, take it for what it's worth. It's the internet. Like you said, could be a troll. Somebody just wants to get a name out or just get a rise or whatever.
It was just brought to my attention that, you know, there were a lot of Chinese people that were quite upset and talking trash who hadn't even seen the podcast and seen my side of it. And I just felt like just because I don't speak the same language, hey, maybe they deserve an explanation, so maybe someone can translate to them that I'm not going to – I got proof. I mean, I got everybody knows where the shark clones came from.
Chris, yeah. I'd be very careful. There's a lot of Chinese. You don't want to piss them all off.
Oh, no, I don't want to. No, I love Chinese. I think I was a Chinese monk in a past life. No. I love Chinese. I'm glad you brought that up, because that was something else that somebody on TFW brought up. He said the Chinese workers are already overworked as it is, and now we're handpicking a team to work after hours, extra hours. Yes, I agree. That sucks. It's not cool. They don't get paid enough. And I will say that when they work extra hours for a third-party company, they get paid a lot more. They get paid way, way more than what they do when they're working in a normal factory.
But that's capitalist mentality anyway. Make them work harder for less. I mean, that's basically the corporate structure.
And plus, we're going by Chinese law. So,
and it's bad here, so
figure right. It out.
Well, that's the reason why they're produced over there and all the factories here closed down.
Right.
Right, and which brings up...
around the buildings.
Say that again?
That's why they have nets surrounding their buildings.
Yeah. Oh, that's... God bless them. God bless them. Oh, go ahead.
No, it's just crazy, you know?
Yeah, it's just crazy. Those nets to stop them, to collect them so they don't commit suicide.
Yeah, it's just tragic. It's just so terrible.
It is. And the problem is that we all feed into it because that's the global commerce.
Well, here's one more thing about the Chinese worker that will explain some things about third parties as well. Chinese New Year. Everybody knows about Chinese New Year and about that month or two that we don't get stuff. Mm-hmm. I want to let everybody know just a little something about the guys making our toys, what their lives are like. They live throughout China. For 10 months of the year, they come and they work in the factories. It takes them 2 weeks to travel by bus and train from wherever province way out in China they live in, and they all come into the factories and they work for 10 months. And because Chinese New Year is only 1 month, but because it takes them 2 weeks to get home and 2 weeks to get back, that's why we have that 2 month delay between, is it January and February? Yeah, January.
And I can say it varies.
January to March.
This is how it is in my business, is that last year, I believe it was in January to February. This year, I think it was February into March, but it does vary every year.
That's what I mean. Exactly. But even though it's only a month-long holiday, they have to take 2 months off because it takes them 2 weeks to get there, 2 weeks to get back. Plus, you understand how terrible would that be that out of 12 months of the year, 10 of it's working way too hard for nothing, yep. And then a month is spent traveling, and you get 1 month off.
You know what? It surprises me that they get those 2 months, that they're given a month to travel.
Well, it's because the
it's a Chinese thing.
All the holidays in China actually are taken very, very seriously. Chinese holidays, production does completely stop. It happens at my business as well. We have to completely pretend those dates don't exist when we're creating our schedules. It is a very, very serious thing. And that to me, I think, is why they do get that time. It's because they do get their asses worked off for the rest of the year, but there's no joke when it comes to those holidays.
Yep, no joke.
It's a cultural thing. Our culture is so different. You'll have people working during Christmas. You'll have people working Thanksgiving, during New Year's. It doesn't matter. In China and also in some other countries as well where we do production, forget about it. It is a complete shutdown.
But yet they don't care if their workers jump off buildings because they're working them too hard for too little money.
Well, you know, they don't...
That fucking holiday is very important.
Yeah. Take a whole month. Take an extra month so you can travel.
So when you come back, you can jump off the building.
Oh, God. It's so sad. But I mean, I really believe all this kind of nonsense is coming to an end for the human population. We're getting past this nonsense. We got a lot of nonsense going on now, but I always feel like it's like when you want to start working out. It's really hard at first, but then it becomes habit. Mm-hmm. You know,
I agree with you, Chris, and I think it's also difficult to see the forest for the trees. Since you're stuck in the moment right now, everything right now seems like it's the worst ever. But when we look back on it, that's when you can compare it to, you know, where you are then and what was before. But anyway, let's get back to you. Anything else you want to clarify? Or you said you had things you wanted to add that you didn't get to last week.
I wanted to, yeah, I'm pretty much, I think anybody else that I might have upset, go ahead, contact me, I'll try to fix it.
Forget them, bro.
I already, you know, said the shout outs for most everybody I could think of. Of course, you know, we both wanted to thank Pia. We love that guy. And then the other things I wanted to talk about were we brought up that multiple, like, the biggest secret being that multiple companies are in the same factory. Like, I've had people come and attack me for that, and I could see why it was such a secret. Like, people, these company owners are mad, right? And I'm like, they're like, what is your proof? And I'm like, well, part of my proof is that when we would have a few extra parts and some other company would have a few extra parts, we would cast the parts on the same cast. They would share, called like piggyback a cast. Mm-hmm. You would just piggyback on somebody else's cast.
Piggyback and, a cast? I love
yeah,
that.
And you've got two totally different third-party stuff, but it's in the same white or whatever, and it's casted on the exact same cast. So nobody could tell me that there was that back in the day, a lot of a vast 90%+ of the companies were made at the same factory. Now it could be completely different. All 1,000 companies could have 1,000 factories for all I know. I don't know. But that was one thing. Oh, this is really fun. It's one of those what could have been kind of deals. It's fun and it'll be a bummer at the same time. The middleman that I had spoke about comes from a very wealthy family, has lots and lots of money, and is very influential in Hong Kong. He has friends in the television industry. Producers, directors, writers, all that stuff, right? He actually worked out a deal to make a cartoon and wanted me to talk to Fanch Project about making their own cartoon with Toyline that went along with it, all legit. Now, everybody that was following Fanch Project at the time knew that they wanted to become legit. They wanted to not copy Hasbro. They didn't want to knock their shit off. They wanted to make their own figures. We saw it. And they wanted to do their own thing. What? Steel Corp, one of the best figures ever. I love that figure.
It is one of the greatest figures ever.
Yeah. Now, I was thinking I was going to contact Fanch Project, and they were going to be like, let's do this. Cartoon and toy line. I thought it was game over. And for the first time, third part, even though it would have been a Chinese cartoon, we would have gotten subtitles. We would have been able to watch it, right? Contacted Fanch Project, and they were right in the middle of making this big-ass deal that they couldn't compromise, and they just couldn't do it. They had this deal and all this product that they had to put out. They didn't have the time. And this guy literally, like, had writers, producers, and director all ready to go. Like, you guys start making the plans, give us the concept art, and we'll make a cartoon out of it. We almost had a Fanch Project cartoon, legit.
Wow. And how long ago was this?
This was about 2014,
2013. Wow. Now, Chris, in that awesome story, there was something I picked up that I wanted to ask you.
Yeah.
You were back in the day. You were in contact with that middleman. So that community was so small that you guys all got in contact with each other. You all had each other's contact information. How did you go about meeting him? How did you go about? Is this through your brother? How did this happen?
It happened because we had to deal with him, and And I guess a lot of the people that lived near him were intimidated by him. So they used the fact that me and him had a good relationship based off of he used to teach me about Chinese history that I was very interested in.
Oh.
And I've got pages, like emails that are just pages of history, on Chinese history and individuals that are just, I love it. But so we knew each other and we were not friends, but I mean, we talked, I mean, yeah, we were, I consider him a friend. He told me stories and that kind of stuff. And he knew, like I said, the Chinese, a lot of the owners were intimidated by him, so they would have me talk to him.
So he was like your work friend, or your work, or the manager at work, or you know that none of the other coworkers wanted to talk to you, and but you had a relationship with him. Just what it
yeah,
sounds like. You had
I didn't work for him. I wasn't employed by him. I just like you know, I would tell him. I'd be like, you know, so and so wants to sell you their product, but they're afraid to talk to you, and this is what they want, and. You know, you're willing to do it. And with me, he never cut. He never tried to. He knew right off the bat I wasn't gonna. If it was fair, like I said, everything was not a major. It was a very small fair. It was about the fun. It was about getting it out there. I mean, we had one particular third party. He didn't care about any of his profit. He put it all back into the company to make another product. He didn't care about the profit. He just wanted people to buy his stuff, to love his stuff. You know what I mean? So anyways,
without telling me what it is, without telling us what it is, did we end up loving it?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Matter of fact, out of the two products he made, the first one had rivals of the same, you know, other companies making the same product, and his blew them out of the water.
Nice, nice.
Great guy in the East Coast. By you.
Oh, where is he? Where is he?
I'll find out. I think he's right behind you.
Now, When you talk to the middleman, did you guys discuss what, other than, you know, obviously discuss what people wanted to sell to him, did he ever say that he was looking for something in particular? Did he care? Did he care at all what people wanted to produce? Or it was
yes.
Just...
Yes. He would, on the companies that he had by the balls, he would actually tell them what they could and couldn't produce. They would present what they wanted to make, and he'd be like, nope, there's no money in it. You know, and or, yeah, I'll make that. You know, he dictates exactly what comes out as far as the ones he's got the stranglehold on. Stranglehold, I don't know, business partnership, whatever it is.
Or the funds. But was he right?
What's that?
Was he right insofar as that whatever he dictated or asked to be made or told him he could only make, did those things sell well? Did he have a good track?
No, he's not. You got to be like us. You got to like be passionate about it to really know what's gonna do well with the fans. You know what I mean? Nobody in a million years would have ever thought to make, not the, Suicide Squad movies. What's the name of the anti-wreckers that MMC is making?
The Mayhem. The anti-wreckers?
Yeah, it's like, you know, there's the wreckers for the Autobots, then the Decepticons. It's Tarn and...
Yeah, they're based on IDW comics, right?
Yeah. They were like the opposite of the wreckers.
Alan, do you remember the Transformer that transformed from an electric chair to a robot?
He's one of them.
He's one of them.
I don't remember the electric chair to the robot, no.
We talked
about it a few shows back.
Yeah. I knew Bill would remember because it's just insane. It's literally an electric chair with the metal dome.
And Megatron was sitting on it. I thought it was just a chair when I seen the picture initially, till Pedro blew me out of the water there.
And then there was another one that was the first one was a gun, or transformed into like a sniper rifle.
Sniper rifle.
Yeah, those were. I never got into those because
I'm pretty sure it's the Mayhem Squad. But basically, it was the Decepticon version of the Wreckers, just the worst, most hardcore killers of them all. And Tarn was a huge character because he's the one that has the face that actually looks like the Decepticon logo.
Yes.
So you would recognize him.
Yeah, that's the one that's coming out soon.
Right. He was, I believe he's the leader of them. But my point is nobody knows about those guys. But MMC knew. It don't matter if they don't know about them. We make them. People are going to look into it, and then they're going to realize, these guys are the Decepticon version of the Wreckers. Sweet. Everybody loves the Wreckers.
And MMC makes a great product.
It's just an example of people with a passion having a better idea of what the fandom wants than the managers of the companies or the money guys.
Brought it back around. Nice. Absolutely. And then Chris,
mm-hmm.
how do you feel about this trend now with this KO trend? We're getting knockoffs of not just Hasbro, but
Kevin Owens.
Sorry.
What's KO? Kevin Owens.
Oh, knockoffs.
Oh, okay. I'm just making sure I know what you're talking.
We're getting knockoffs, and we've always gotten knockoffs of Hasbro products, and it was hit or miss. It wasn't always great. There's tons of knockoffs out there of G1. If you want the full set of Dinobots from 1985 in the original box, you can get a knockoff version of that. That are pretty close. They have issues, and I've seen they tend to have issues or whatever. But today, now we are getting knockoffs of not just Hasbro but third party pieces that are either made larger or that have been enlarged or made smaller in different scales that are as good quality as the originals or better, at least better than Hasbro. And the reason I bring that up, for instance, this is Hound from Age of Extinction, one of the few big formers that I really, really like. Well, if you notice, unless you get something to scale, here's the fans project Highbrow. Look how big this guy is.
Yeah, he's huge. Oh, I could tell. I could tell by your hand. Yeah.
This thing's a monster. I mean, I can't cover it. All right.
He's a beast.
And the deluxe size was about 4 or 5 inches. It has die cast in his chest, and it has die cast in his back, which ends up being in all form is the truck. Okay.
Nice.
It comes with all these weapons, and it comes with the Dr. Wu add-on set that gives him the netting, that gives him makes him a little fatter, a little rounder, with the bullets, the grenade.
I love that upgrade too.
So they also upscaled the Dr. Wu, add-on kit. It's and not for nothing, this cost probably just a little bit more than what the Dr. Wu add-on kit cost.
Wow.
All right.
The whole thing.
We're talking about $60-$65.
Yes.
All right.
And it came with all of that.
Yes. Now, the one that I got did not come with a box, because they actually make a box, but it does have instructions. And it takes them less than, and the way the shipping works, it took less than a week. It took about a week, actually, to get to me on the East Coast. I mean, this thing is Oh, and they improved it. I'm sorry. They also improved on Hasbro's original design. If people that know this figure, are gonna, and I don't know if you know, but originally, this flap that's on his back will be covering his arm. That's what the original toy. With this one, they re-engineered and redesigned it so that it has a strut.
Oh, wow.
That holds it and puts it on his back.
Nice.
Which actually,
how heavy is that thing?
I'm sorry?
How heavy is that thing?
My hand is hurting a little bit. It's pretty heavy. I would say this is a few pounds.
That's a lot of die-cast, dude.
That's a lot of die-cast in the front. I mean,
and I just found out the price of die-cast is twice as much as plastic. That's all.
Exactly two times as much?
Exactly two times. I thought it was like 5 or 10 times as much, but it turns out...
I think it would be a lot more, too, yeah.
Yeah, they said it's only twice as much. But, so I mean... That's sick, dude, because you know that thing. I love it when it's got all that die-cast. You feel like you could throw it at somebody and knock them out, and you're just like, this is a man's collectible.
Exactly.
I was about to say toy, but no, collectible.
Now, how would Dr. Wu feel about that, or any type of third-party guy that sees that, hey, the MMC Feral Rex is being mass-produced in a larger scale, and it's not bad at all, and people are buying it, and it's cheaper than buying the original MMC by a sixth. You could buy for $100 to get the individual figures. It's going to cost you $600. Mm-hmm. How does that happen? Does that cut into the profits of the third party, or are we talking about something that this?
Did we go over? Did we go over on the last show about whenever someone's done with a mold or cast, they'll just sell it to anybody and they can go and produce 1,000 of them or tens of thousands of them?
I'm not sure.
Because, I mean, that is a thing, like, where I'm not saying Takara, I'm not Cosmic, I'm saying in third parties, like with Dr. Wu, you would find, like, the Dr. Wu Protector Face upgrade, it was sold out everywhere, right? For, like, a year or two, it had been sold out. But if you went to Chimungmung, it was in stock. And they had thousands of pieces. And that's because I asked my brother, you know, because I would report to him. Every time I saw someone selling our product that shouldn't have it, I'd say, how did so-and-so get this? And he'd say, oh, Dr. Wu was done with that. He didn't want to do any more runs, so he sold the cast to so-and-so so they can make all they want. And I don't know if that's the case with that figure and Dr. Wu, but I know that back in the day, like, as far as KOing stuff, everything was under check because everybody was around everybody, and... Like, literally, whenever that company, Guilty, tried to rip us off, all we did is contacted the stores and said, hey, this company, Guilty, that's trying to sell you this product, that's our design, and that's our product that they stole from us.
That sounds familiar, that company. What did Guilty, do you remember what Guilty produced?
Everything they produced was a copy of a third-party company's product. Mm. Yeah, they just stole. I mean, it was like literally, yeah, I'm guilty of stealing your shit. That's the name of the company. And what we did is we just told all the stores, we said, if you sell the product, we're not selling to it anymore. And that just put an end to it. They had to throw that shit away. All the money they spent trying to copy our shit, they had to throw it away because they couldn't sell it to anyone. But right now...
They couldn't sell on Alibaba or somewhere else like that?
Well, I'm sure they could try to sell it to China. Like I said, there's a huge market. But also, like I was saying, in my day, there weren't 30 companies like people are trying to tell me there, or 30 factories like people are trying to tell me now. There was only the one. You know, I don't know. Fine, there might have been, somebody might have bought and built their own factory and only shared it with a couple other people. But that doesn't make sense because we were making their stuff in our factory. I don't know. I've been told a lot of things. I'm just going to tell you what is my experience. And my experience is there was one factory.
Yeah, and that's, that's all you could do, Chris.
All you could do I lost audio.
You lost
audio?
Can
anybody hear?
I can hear you. I
can hear you.
We can hear you.
Someone's cut his mic.
It was Pedro. It was Pedro because he wanted to talk more.
I think that's what it was, but no, even cooler, I'm pretty sure that what cut his mic was the third-party middleman.
That's what I was about to say.
Chinese. The Chinese are hacked into his system.
You're right. The Chinese hackers at the NSA.
Did the battery die on the headset?
Can he see the chat?
There's no batteries on this.
Oh, we can barely hear. I can hear him a little bit.
Yeah, put the headset on. It might be working again. We heard you lightly. Say,
yes.
Chris, can you hear us?
I can hear. Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
We can barely hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Oh, it's still low.
You gotta check the settings.
Check the settings again on the sprocket.
Go in the middle of the screen and check it because it's I just love that they're fascinating this whole thing about the third party because it really came out of one little what looked like one piece that the way it was sold, the way it was produced looked like it was made from somebody's garage.
Mm-hmm.
It was a nice piece. It was a head upgrade and weapons and a bumper and I think maybe a spoiler for Cliff Jumper.
Yeah.
All right. That thing was. But from that we got to. From that, we got to this.
Yeah.
Well.
Okay. And which is incredible, and it's a huge, huge industry. And let me tell you, this is my newest acquisition. All right, Alan, do you know what this is?
I'm so jealous.
I don't know what that is.
This is MP10. You don't recognize MP10?
But he's mini.
Yeah, it's a smaller one. Oh,
yeah, okay. This is MP10. I mean, he looks exactly like MP10, Alan. Exactly.
You've got MP10. You've got MPP10. You've got MMP10.
And he owes me $90. And he owes me
$90. I ordered this a long time ago.
I'm joking.
I wouldn't be stupid to show it to you.
Hey. I want to see a Master-Made Titan knockoff, by the way. You know why? Because then I could actually buy one. So somebody make a Titan, all right?
Now, wait a minute. Are we talking about the same thing that I screwed up on the last show, Master-Made? You guys are talking about a Metroplex. It's Make Toys Utopia.
Now, wait a minute. Are we talking about the same thing that I screwed up on?
Thank you, Kevin. Thank you. Continue, Chris.
I am so weirded. Okay. you were talking about Make Toys Utopia whenever I was showing the SG Prime, right? That was another moment that I was having anxiety and I wasn't able to do two things at once. But is that what you're talking about now, the Make Toys Utopia?
No. He's talking about the Master-Made SD Super Deformed Transforming Metroplex.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And you know,
okay.
Bill,
I'm sorry.
Bill, if you go to that show, that toy show, someone's bound to have it.
Well, the guy at NJCC has it, and he only wants $1.50 for it. That's a good price, but it was
get it for $1.50.
I don't know.
Get it for $1.50.
WWF this time, I think.
All right.
I know.
Just saying.
The problem is I'm not gonna get the other ones either, and I'm gonna be pissed off. The Trypticon and whatever he's named, and then
Omega Supreme's coming up next. Yeah.
They're awesome. I love them. You know.
Yeah. The fact that they transform and the engineering, and I love that it's I don't mind when they redesign them and give us a new modern look. I just love that. I love what they did with those.
Yeah.
But, hey, I'm really sorry. I kind of avoided the KO question and allowed to go off into extra areas because, to be honest, I'm real sketchy about sharing my feelings on it. I guess if I express stuff as just being my opinion or feeling, but because of my other knowledge, all I gotta say is, that the people that say, no, there are no KO toys that are better than the originals, that is negative. That is wrong. It was first proved with the KO Henkei or United Classics Ultra Magnus Shattered Glass Prime and
That was years ago.
But that's what I'm saying. It first started with that. Those were not only the same quality plastic or better, but ratchets were added to where there were normally just friction joints, and where Hasbro had chose to leave windows out to save money, they actually put the windows in. So you actually got a figure that was better than the original. Now, whether or not that's right...
That's a
personal thing.
Well, you know what? I've heard the argument. I've seen it online, and people have argued. People have said this, that it's very easy to make a better version of something that's already been made because it's already
It's already been made. All you have to do, it's just like that blaster you were talking about. If you already got the mold and you're like, hey, it'd be cooler to have them do the splits. You've already got the mold. Everything's there. Just make a few tweaks, and now you can do the splits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, it just sucks that I bought into the other one, but I'm happy.
Why is it so important for you to have Blaster spread his legs that wide?
That's something I'm gonna.
How
have to
are you posing with. Him?
That's something I'm gonna have to bring up with my therapist.
Oh.
You know,
ooh, you're bringing your love to a whole another level.
It's funny, when I was a kid, I had all my little G.I. Joes lined up in this box. And they were all posed the exact same way for space purposes, but, you know, they're lying on their back with their arms crossed, with their hands, their crotch. And that's how they're all lined up. And it was easy for me to pick them up that way, put them down that way. And years later, I'm thinking to myself, yeah, that's something to tell a therapist about.
That's morbid. That is morbid. I was like, that's the whole time I'm thinking to myself, so you had a graveyard in your room. Like, that was your thing.
Yes, all my toys were these shoebox graves.
Alan's room was the only place where G.I. Joes actually died.
Where they actually die. And they right back to life every day.
Yeah, that used to be my garage. Like until 2000 when I took them out and I was like, oh, wait a minute, these are cool.
Oh, don't you love that whenever you forget about a figure and you come back and you revisit it and you're like, oh my god, I have that whole feeling that I got when I first got it again.
Yeah.
You know? Listen, you know where you could get those figures again? BigBoyCollectibles.com.
BigBoyCollectibles.com.
BigBoyCollectibles.com. .com.
If you want
BigBoyCollectibles.com.
G.I. Joe's that you had as a child, BigBoyCollectibles.com.
That was a good segue.
Chris, you have any interest in the San Diego Comic Con Transformers G.I. Joe exclusive?
Oh my god, don't tell me. I haven't even seen it yet, dude. I charged up my iPad so we could go over to TFCon releases.
Yes.
But I followed the Comic-Con. They didn't have much listed.
Nah, it was the Megatron. They showed off the best thing I saw that they showed off the new Titans Returns Megatron. And it's okay. I'm hoping the Takara one will be better.
Yeah, it probably will be.
But at least he doesn't have a mask like Galvatron.
Oh.
So So what were the cross? Because I love my G.I. Joe Transformer crossovers.
They went back to that with the same style packaging. It is Power Glide as the Rattler.
That's awesome.
Okay, and then a Hiss Tank as this beefy take on the Hiss Tank that was designed in 2006 for Soundwave.
Yeah, I have that one. It's funny that you just mentioned the other.
Not Soundwave, not Shock. Not
Shockwave. Is it right, Soundwave?
And it's a different mold of a tank.
Yeah.
It's a Hiss Tank, but it's a different mold of it.
Oh, no shit.
I'm waiting for Hasbro. I guess Hasbro is going to start selling the SDCC stuff on Monday, right?
Yes and no, because there's going to be a few thousand people who are going to be F5ing for the next from Monday till about Thursday, Wednesday or Thursday when they finally put them up.
Yeah.
That's what happens every year.
Did you get your Wily Kit and Wily Cat?
Nah.
You better ask.
What's interesting this year, Big Bad Toy Store usually puts up San Diego Comic-Con exclusives, like the big ones, the big guns.
Yeah.
They have not done it at all this year. They've had the usual Entertainment Earth and minor stuff.
But I want to hear what Bill was going to say, but ask who?
Ask Gil. Good luck.
Oh, Gil got a few of them?
I don't know. I think he only got one this time.
All right.
But, hey, Alan, listen, I saw a picture of this guy. He was he's in one of the wrestling groups. I guess he has a site where he sells stuff, and he had like six.
Oh, the Shockmasters! I saw that.
Six or seven of those eco-friendly shopping bags, full. I mean, full to the top. Double. Each stack has two of Shockmasters. How does that happen?
I'll tell you how it happens. It doesn't surprise me because when I was at San Diego Comic-Con 2 years ago, I saw the exact same thing, bags and bags. What it is that it's these retailers who all, you know, they're all at San Diego selling their wares, and they're all making their deals with each other to, you know, well, I got some extra stock here. How about I give you some of your extra stock? You give me some of your extra stock. That's how they do it. It's a thing among the retailers.
But I've seen this before. But Maddie would do that with a little independent mom and pop internet shop.
Maddie has always there's always been a picture of somebody walking out with a million and one things from Maddie
all the time. Remember? What was it? What was it that? It was either Heroes or it was something. What are the San Diego exclusives from a few years back from Maddie? I saw the same exact thing. Bags and bags of the same thing that people were walking out with.
And I'd love to get a Shockmaster. And here I'm not even probably going to be
able to. What is a Shockmaster?
It's the guy with the video that we got flagged for by WWF.
Yeah. Bill, he won't sell that.
I thought we were doing Transformers third party.
We are. I apologize.
I couldn't go without
talking about something I know about.
Just busting chops. Our viewers are going to
sleep. Put Chris to sleep.
Wake up, Chris.
I'm just looking for the G.I. Joe Transformer exclusives.
I just saw Chris was busy, so I figured I'd take control, take the reins here before you started yapping.
But, you know, since we are talking, you know, San Diego, just so everybody knows, we will be back on tomorrow night. We'll be talking San Diego news. We'll be talking other news. So
around 5 Eastern tomorrow.
Yep. Double header.
We'll be talking a lot of reveals from San Diego Comic Con. I gotta say, if you are what a great time to be alive.
Yo, this year, it's slaying, man. Just slaying.
Out of control.
You thought Toy Fair showed off a lot, man, this year, but.
Yeah.
Toy Fair got what's going on right now.
And let me tell you, it might be a trend because TFCon had some insane reveals. There's some great three-party. I'm gonna have to hit up a bank. Steal old lady's pocketbook.
Not hit up a bank. Knock off a bank.
Oh, okay. Are you sure I don't want to hit it off?
Yeah, and you know, with TFCon, when I saw all those reveals, I was expecting to see a slew of pre-orders. So far, the only pre-order that I've seen has been the Skyfire. And,
thank God, Alan. Thank God.
Yeah, and there was one other thing.
It would be a disaster
It would be a disaster.
It would be a disaster if they all came out at the same time.
Yeah, it would be. So Phoenix and Lupus were both put up for pre-order. Phoenix is put up at $220. It's coming in April of 17.
Well, tell the people what a Phoenix is. Actually, maybe most of them know what it is.
Yeah, so Phoenix is basically Skyfire. It's a third-party Skyfire. It's from Fans Toys. It's gorgeous. You know, it is up at BigBadToyStore.com.
So and all of you, so I hope nobody pays, I hope very few of you pay secondary market prices for Kronos. This is being made by Fan Toys, so this is going to be everybody's de facto masterpiece Skyfire. And Fan Toys, it's a great product, and it is about 4 to 5 inches taller than MP10.
Yeah.
The original. It's insane.
It's a good rule to never assume anything, but when it comes to Fan Toys quality nowadays, I think it's fairly safe to assume.
Absolutely. There are a few companies, according to Chris, maybe they're all the same. I don't know if Chris, if I've spoken to you about this. This is that Fans Toys that I told you that doesn't have a great design. This is clumsy.
That's Fans Project, right?
Fans Project, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Fans Project.
Looks like a robot right there in that form. It just looks.
Well,
like
true. If you twirl it up, around.
I can promise you right one there. Thing. I'm not allowed to say anything about Fans Project, but I can promise you one thing. All their future products and designs are going to be even better than what they've ever been in the past, and they're going to be. The designs will be better, therefore the actual products will be better.
Well, I gotta say
and they're already the echelons of the thing. You're upset with Brainstorm.
I'm not upset. Actually, what I was going to say was, as clumsy as this looks, I love the aesthetic. They have a particular aesthetic with the way they're
like
evolving,
it.
with the line work. Okay,
right, I like
and, at first, when I saw pictures of it, I was like, oh, that looks awful. In hand, it's, you know what, it's charming.
All right? I love it.
And it's an ingenious transformation. It really is.
Yeah.
I ended up actually liking it a lot more than I thought I would. But that's great to hear about Fans Project. Fans Project, that they're gonna kick it up a notch.
Oh, yeah, like they... Man, they are serious about kicking it up a big notch. Like, it's almost like they're almost disappointed. I'm not saying that's what they are, but it's almost like they're disappointed in some of their products. So they're like, forget all this, and we're doing it. We're spending more money, and we're going to pay more. We're going to be more hands-on and make better product.
Well, here's the thing. I would say the number one problem isn't so much making better product. I think the number one problem is that they're still making these really well intricately designed transformers that are chug scale. All right, that go great in your classics, your generations, your Uniteds, your Universe collections. All right, I don't know how much of that market is still left because everybody and their mother. Is doing masterpiece scale.
Yeah. Well, you gotta understand though. When you say you don't know how many, we've had to think about this stuff before, so we broke it down. You know how I said there were three different classes of collectors?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I don't.
Well,
I don't
tell me again because I don't remember. I don't know if you said it online.
I said it on the podcast last time about how they saw how much money we spent. And they took the three different portions of us, the lowest spending, the middle, and the high, to figure out about how much we were spending on third parties to send out products to counteract and take away money. So nobody had money for third parties. They just bought all official, which was genius.
Mm.
Now, I'm sorry. I'm getting like a loud noise. I'm sorry. One second.
Ignore the voices in your head. They'll talk to you later.
That loud noise apparently is Pedro.
it sounds like a train going through my head. I don't even know.
That's Alan's. That's the Alan's biker friend.
No, not this time. That wasn't me this time. No bikers. No bikers. That wasn't me. God.
Yeah, that one's all upstairs there, Chris.
Okay, what was I saying?
We were talking about the three types of collectors.
Yeah, anyway, so you had mentioned about the chugs and about everything being made masterpiece. Well, there's two aspects of that. One aspect, masterpiece is Hasbro Takara set the standard for the Hasbro scale. We all agree on that. And yeah. They started with the MP10, and they based everything, and even the third parties are basing it off of that. But there is genius to that, because they knew not everybody could afford all of the masterpieces. they know that not everybody can afford masterpieces, and that they're not going to make every masterpiece that everybody wants. So remember that collector's line I told you about, the generations, like the Voyager scale? Well, that works with the MP line if you really think about it on some level or not. You know, I could bring this hot rod and grab my Springer, and they're the same height. You know what I mean? Maybe Springer's even a little bit.
I understand that from Marvel. I understand that from Hasbro's end.
My point is the majority of the collectors are chug collectors.
Are they chug?
Yes,
They might be chug, and I understand, especially particularly the Hasbro stuff in the shelves, because that's cheaper. But what about the third party collector?
That's the reason why Fans Project speaks to that, because they realize that 70% of the market is chug collectors.
But the new ones aren't doing as well as Fans Toys. Fans Toys is Gigapower, G Creations.
Make Toys, they're making masterpieces.
Make Toys is making. MMC are making masterpieces. It seems like everybody's falling on top of each other to concentrate on the masterpiece scale. I love chug scale, don't get me wrong, and I don't mind adding to chug scale if it's a great piece.
Oh, don't get Pedro wrong at all. If you look at his collection, he literally will get an inch figure to a 24-48-inch figure. He doesn't care. As you can see about every Optimus Prime ever.
Yeah. Well, please don't get it like... Don't get it twisted as far as third-party collectors are not like normal collectors. Normal collectors won't spend over $50 for a Transformer on average.
Oh, yeah.
We're in a different category as it is to begin with.
Yeah, and the major advantage I imagine that third parties have over Hasbro is that they can drop production of something on a dime and change it if the market changes, the trends change, whereas Hasbro has to plan out this stuff 2 years in advance.
Mm. Well, they still lose a lot of money, and it could ruin their company, but I see what you're saying, definitely. But all I'm saying is that the market is actually you have more people buying Hasbro stuff with every once in a while when they are really lucky and they get their birthday or Christmas money and they buy a third party chug to go along with the rest
that.
Of theirs.
I believe that.
But that's the majority of the money of the people, because the majority of the collectors only buy Hasbro Takara. The majority of Transformer sales period in the world.
And not even Takara.
Hasbro Takara. It's Hasbro.
At least Americans.
It's Hasbro. So then you're taking and then you got to say the third-party people are even different. First off, you got to get away from whether or not it's okay to collect third-party if you're only Hasbro. Then, do I have the extra money? They're a completely different group. So you're going to have – so because they're people with more money, you're going to be able to make more masterpieces and sell more expensive stuff, especially if you recognize a chug four or five years ago – was the same price as a Masterpiece now in the third-party world. We paid $100.
Yeah.
We paid $100 for all of our chugs, and now the Masterpieces are, like, almost all of them $100 around.
They've gotten a little bit over, though. Now they're getting
some of them are, like, 170.
130. And some of them are 130, like the DX9 Blitzwing. Some places have it for $130. You know, you have to pay shipping on top of that, but that's not bad for what you get. You get a, you get a beefy, tall. I think he's taller
before
than the...
Before that, all you got was a Classics that wasn't all that great for $95.
It was shipping. It was over $100 for the City Commander add-on kit.
Warbot Defender was like $79 plus shipping, you know, which could be a lot. Assaulter was $90 at least. You know, like everything was close to $100. And now we're getting third party Masterpieces for close to $100. So you see what I'm saying? It's like, yeah, amongst the third party people, we're buying less chugs because we look at it like this. Why buy a Chug Brainstorm or Weird Wolf? Fans Project made a Weird Wolf. And now somebody else is making a Weird Wolf.
Fan Toys.
Isn't it Make Toys?
No, the Werewolf is... Weird... I want to say...
I thought it was Make Toys, but it might be Fan
Toys. I will look it up. I don't think it's Make... I'll look it up. I'll confirm.
Right, but like... If you look at it, like, the price difference from us, why spend 90 when we can spend 130 and have the Masterpiece version? It's only $40 more to the definitive one.
And here's where I would talk about collusion. Maybe it's just they saw that there was a Werewolf being made. Or maybe they said, look, I'm releasing a Chug Weird Wolf. Why don't you hold back and produce your Masterpiece a little bit later? If they were both announced at the same time, a lot of people would pick one over the other. And Chris, it's Fan Toys that's making the Weird Wolf.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Wonderful. I've just noticed that Make Toys have really gone out the box, you know, with the headmasters and stuff, with MP headmasters.
Oh, man.
Just,
oh, the headmasters. You know. I'm going to tell you, I prefer the Make Toys headmasters to what Fans Toys is doing now. I'm not crazy with the Werewolf all form.
Oh, yeah, really?
Yeah, I'm not too crazy about it. It's not terrible, but it's not for me.
Yeah, the Fans Project one was really good. The
oh, yeah. In that scale, it's great. And again, Fans Project, I don't know how they do it, but every one of their figures has some kind of unique engineering to that figure. They don't carry over the engineering of everything over from one figure to the other. And they just Fans Toys are fun puzzles.
Well, isn't it amazing what they did with their Headmaster line? And every figure has a very special aspect to their transformation that's very unique and different. Like that Chrome Dome, having that chest actually slide off of the top half of the body onto the pelvic area, completely separating it from the top half of the body and making it a part of the bottom half.
And having a rail system,
beautiful.
A flat system that works. That it worked and wasn't flimsy. It was
exactly
sturdy. Genius.
It was perfect. Yeah. And then the next figure was the Brainstorm with the really impressive transformation as well.
Brainstorm was also the way his chest shrunk. The shrinking of the chest is awesome.
Right. So I like that a lot, and I think they should be given credit, and I think that's why they continue with the Chug. You know, whether or not they're going to start making Masterpiece, I have no idea, but I know that they make great product. Like you said, that figure is fantastic, but they want to up their game. They just want to get better and better and better.
Absolutely. Well, Chris, I think you've I think you've said. I'm glad you gave me the opportunity to clear the air. I think you are too kind to your detractors. I think you built empires on the bodies of the detractors. And I appreciate everything that you've shared with us.
Thank you.
I am a degenerate third party fan. I love what they do. I wish there was another way. I kind of wish I lived in Asia so I could get immediate access to it. I didn't have to pay the import. But is there anything else that you might have left off that you wanted to add for today?
No, we can. I mean, if we're gonna have another show, if you have me back on, then I'll talk about some other stuff. Like I wanted to, I've got some other things that I was gonna touch on, but if we got time for another time, I'll just save it for then. It's nothing huge.
Nothing huge. I have something huge to share. Plastic Empire, the Plastic Empire. I think is that what this is called? Okay. The Plastic Empire is going to expand. We like to add Chris Sterrett to our family, and Chris and I, with Alan and Bill, at a rotating basis, we are going to have our own third-party Transformers, all of the above show. This is going to be about robots that turn into other things, okay? It's going to be about new ones. It's going to be about old ones. We in our collections, we have a lot of the earlier ones that we'd like to show off and talk about. All right, there's some that I still have some in package that I haven't even attached to the figure. Maybe it's high time I did that. All right, maybe we can do that on the video. But Chris will be there to give us his amazing insight on what all of these on what is the Transformers world. Both Hasbro and third party.
Yes, thank you so much for welcoming me. Alan.
We're looking forward to it.
Bill, Pedro, you guys are so rad. You know how much I respect you, how much I love you guys. I really do appreciate it. It means a whole lot to me. No, I was not an attention seeker, nor am I. I just, with you guys, like, I didn't have as much problem with my anxiety as I thought. I had a good time talking to you guys. Now, I felt like most of the show was wasted on corrections for the last show. It would have been a lot more fun to be able to talk to you guys about fun stuff, but
you wanted to get it off your chest.
And I enjoy every minute of it, and I appreciate you guys giving me a platform to do so. Thank you.
Absolutely.
And thank you for having me. Thank you. I mean it from the bottom of my heart.
It's an organic show, Chris, so I think that the idea of you being able to respond to comments that have been made since the last show, I think just it's organic that should happen.
Absolutely. And you know what? I really value your insight. And you know what we value? You are honest, all right? And you're you seem to be an open book. So this is something that I think will work well in when we talk about things now that we're passionate about, which is going to be the Transformers behind you in your collection, all right? The collection, the Transformers in my collection. And I'm including third party and Hasbro stuff that's coming up. There's going to be another TFCon in the States soon. Okay, just love to see if they have any new reveals.
Yeah.
There's just a lot of things out there. And obviously, anybody has any interest in adding or asking Chris about any more information. I did want to, the other thing we could talk about, I did want to ask you why certain things are made and not others, why certain scales at certain times are made and not others, but we will get that on our first show. We hope to be through our first show in 2 weeks, which will be on a Saturday, but we will keep everybody posted, and then for me, Alan, or should I say for Alan, Bill, Chris, and I, thank you. Please make sure to check us out on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube at theplasticempire.com. Okay, don't forget, all you Joe fans that are looking to get some of the modern era or some of the classic stuff. Okay, don't forget
BBC.
Bad collectibles.
Bigboycollectibles.com.
Yeah, check us out.
I'm not good with alliterations.
Check us out on Facebook, The Plastic Empire, Skype, TPE at theplasticempire.com. You could always catch us live during the show on Skype. You know, we could talk live while we're on air. You know, chat with us, and we'll bring up some of your topics on there. Instagram, The Plastic Empire. Twitter is _PlasticEmpire_. Obviously, our email is TPE@theplasticempire.com. Be sure to check us out on our website, theplasticempire.com. Check us out on iTunes, Stitcher Radio, any podcast app out there you can find us. Please, on iTunes, throw us a 5-star rating and tell everybody how great we are, or just tell us we suck, or at least Pedro.
Yeah, well, I really hope
or
that
me.
People will comment.
Or me.
I hope people, please comment on how aggravating, obnoxious, and annoying I am. Please, I need to know. Please.
And
comment everywhere and anywhere, especially on YouTube. I would appreciate if you commented on YouTube, okay? And if you think Chris is a liar, you know what? Comment on that too. Comment away.
Yeah, check us out on YouTube as well, The Plastic Empire. Subscribe, like, share. Shares are better than likes. That's all I ever say. So please share. I'd rather you share than like it. However, I like both. So you share it, it gets out there.
We all appreciate it.
Yes, these are important messages that we want to share with the rest of the world.
Yep.
I don't know that they're important, but we want to share it with the rest of the world.
Oh, no, they're important. Like, it, for example, love and peace to all of you. That's very important to me.
Namaste.
Namaste. I love that, too.
Asaya.
Oh, Tyrone Xavier Slaughter. He has it tattooed on him. Namaste. Oh, and he wrote a book called Namaste. He's a big collector in New York. He's in, he's by you. He's in Astoria. You guys should hang out with him.
Oh, you know what? You should, you know, I mean, I don't know. After seeing me on 2 podcasts, he may not want to. But any local collectors that would like to get in, I would love to meet up. I love nothing better than talking toys, and I would love nothing better than talking Transformers, you know, and hang out.
Tri-State
What's that?
Sorry, go ahead, Chris.
Well, I was just saying what he was saying about people, about his personality or whatever.
Oh, don't worry about it, Chris.
Like, trust me, people. Like, if you have a party and if you don't have someone like Pedro there, it's going to suck.
I agree with that.
So
he's a little easier in person. I will admit.
So realize that we've got different kinds of people in this world, and we're all awesome for different reasons. And Pedro's the party guy.
You know what? Different strokes for different folks. It's fine.
Yes, of course.
And it's absolutely fine.
Let's end this. Yeah, if you're local, man, you're in New Jersey, New York, PA, Connecticut, Delaware, hit us up. Tri-State Vipers on Facebook. We have a page and a group. So hit us up. You know, we love to hang out with local guys, and we do a barbecue every year. So
we do barbecues. We go on toy hunts. We go on statewide toy hunts. We'll take a Saturday and hit everyone in a particular area, state, or city like Long Island.
Oh, well then, Toy Detox, we got Tyler up there by you. He needs to join in on the fun.
We should do this off the air.
Ha! My bad. I love everybody. God bless all of you.
I started it. I started it.
God bless the world.
Okay. Yeah, myself. All right. Pedro's anxious to get off, so
he's gonna take a piss.
Peace, and we'll see you next time.
Love and peace.
Peace.
Tomorrow, as a matter of fact, 5 p.m. Eastern, estimated time.
Mañana.
Because we know Pedro's gonna be late.
Mañana.
Peace.
Peace.
Late.